what's engineering? And he goes, everything. And I was like, what? You need to be more specific here. What is it? And he goes, everything. And it wasn't until years later that I realized that's a fairly accurate answer. I'm Shalene Theo Smith, and I'm a mechanical engineer for HEXBUG. The engineering mentality, the mind that, oh, you look at something and you see how it should work, or you look at it and you're like, whoa, how does this work? How can I design this better? Kind of came later in life for me. I grew up with three brothers who were engineers, and I still had no idea what engineering was until I was in college and going to school for graphic design. My brother, who was studying electrical engineering, was like, you're really good at math, and I think you ought to look into engineering because you'd be really good at it. You like science and everything. I was like, but I've always wanted to be an artist, Brandon. So then I went and talked to the engineering department chair at the college, and I said, you know, look, this is kind of my history. I've been in special ed. I'm good at math, but I've struggled with it in the past, but I have an art background. Do you think I'm getting it over my head if I do switch? And he said, honestly, you're going to have a little bit of an advantage because you're going to be able to see the aesthetics and the function and marry them together in a way that most engineers can't, because most engineers tend to say, function, 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 and then we have art people over here going, no, it has to be pretty. It has to look good. And we're like, no, it has to work. So having that background has been able to really make my job work better. I design toys for kids. Basically, I'm Santa's elf. Right now, my projects are completely consumed by junk bots. The art department will hand me a design or a rendering of what they want a character or a robot to look like, and then I'll go through and make it function, make it moldable, and make it so it can actually be used as a toy. A lot of people who are in engineering will come back and say, oh, I played with this STEM toy, or this, or this, or this, or I was in robotics, and I got to do this and build this and everything. And I realized that I had signs from when I was a kid that I could have really enjoyed engineering, but I wasn't looking for them, and it wasn't available to me in the way that it was so much. Even though I had, you know, three brothers who all went into engineering, it just wasn't a thing that even ever occurred to me. And I think that's why I kind of wanted to get into designing toys specifically. I said all the way through college, you know, I want to go design toys. I want to design STEM toys because I want to be able to give, especially little girls, the opportunity that I didn't get. I had Barbies, so I want to make sure that, you know, my daughter gets that chance so that she can choose if that's what she wants to do, or if she wants to do something else, that's great too. We all have different things to bring to the table. It's important that I think that girls have the opportunity to get into engineering because it is a mainly male field. And that's fine. I don't have anything against them at all. It's just we need more of the viewpoint from different perspectives. Because without that perspective, you may be missing a solution that you just can't see. But you know you have the mind of an engineer when you're looking, when you're take a break from studying for a final and you go to a park just to let your brain just melt a little bit and not think about studying, and you look at the corkscrew on the slide and you're sitting there trying to figure out the calculations of that helix and you know, comparing it to a spring. You know that you're an engineer when all these little things that you've learned are now applied to things that you went, huh? Wait, this isn't what I thought it was anymore.
I'm Shalene Smith, and it's my pleasure to celebrate Engineering Week with you.